The internet is something good for the society and for the individuals. People use the network to learn, work, do business, have fun, make friends. Everybody agrees that we have to preserve the internet and we have to guarantee its continuous development. The internet depends on technology. It uses a protocol, which is a set of rules that allows computer and other electronic devices talk to each other. The heart of the internet is the IP, or internet protocol. It gives a numeric address to each device connected to the network, allowing the information to find a way to its destination. Since 1983, the internet uses IP version 4 or IPv4, but there aren't more free addresses to connect new devices and people. We have to change the heart of the network, allowing it to continue to grow and evolve. The internet needs IPv6. But how does this affect you? This video explains what is IPv6 in plain English. This is John. He is a typical internet user. Without IPv6, John may have some problems in his future. He will notice that some of the websites and social networks are slower. In some, for instance, he will not be able to watch videos. Some websites simply will not load anymore. He will also have problems when trying to play online with his friends. Some video and audio calls will not work well. The sound and the image will be crappy. John's hobby is photography. He shares tons of photos with his friends using torrents, but this also will not work anymore. Talking about his problems with a friend who is an internet expert, John discovers that they are caused by his ISP. The ISP began sharing IP addresses using a technique called carrier-grade NAT or CGNAT. This means that dozens of people share the same network address. The price of the internet access will also increase over time. The internet will not grow as fast as it used to, and it will be more and more difficult to uncover fraud and other online crimes. John and many other internet users will not be very happy with this situation. This is Grace. She is also an internet user, but she will have a much more interesting experience than John in the coming years. Let's imagine Grace in a scenario where the deployment of IPv6 will be successful. When she moves to her new home, she will be delighted with lamps that change colors and can be controlled by her phone or tablet. The lights will glow softly in the morning to wake her, and the air conditioning will be adjusted automatically knowing that she's coming from work at night. She will find a large number of network devices in the future. Grace will wear smart clothes to constantly monitor her health, and her car will send a message every time it needs maintenance. Social networking, file sharing, video conferencing and games will run better and better, and will be very impressive. Grace will be happy because more and more people will be connected to the network. Digital inclusion will be a reality. She and many other users may have never heard of IPv6, but they will be very happy with this new internet. Change the heart of the internet. The technology that is implicit in the whole network is not an easy task. It's like a real heart transplant. The patient's blood is temporarily diverted to a machine which operates simultaneously as lung and heart. This allows a successful transplant. However, a patient cannot be connected to the machine for a long time. Similarly, the address sharing, the CGNAT, can be used as a technique to make the internet work for a while, allowing the deployment of the new technology. But only with IPv6 as the new heart, the internet will continue to grow and develop as we want. The success of this technological change depends on many different people and companies. Equipment vendors, software developers, content and service providers on the internet, and ISPs. It also depends on John, Grace, and on you. Some of the equipment you use to access the network are ready for IPv6. For example, your computer is definitely ready, but your smartphone might not be, depending on the operating system used. The same is true for your game console, your wireless router or smart TV. Some sites and services on the internet have been IPv6 ready for some time now. Sites such as Google, Facebook, Yahoo, Netflix, YouTube, and thousands of others. However, several e-commerce sites, banks, and government sites are not yet ready. already. Perhaps they haven't realized the urgency or seriousness of the situation. You also depend on your ISP to access the network. Some ISPs are underage to run the internet using IPv6, others aren't. The most important thing now is, when buying a new smartphone, a new software for your computer, or switching your ISP, verify if it has IPv6 and accept only if it is IPv6 ready. You can also call your bank, send an email to your favorite online store, or contact your ISP and ask how they are preparing for this new internet. If they not know what you are talking about, you should really check the other options in the market.